Thank you. good evening and welcome to the commencement ceremony for the class of 2023. It is a special night not only for the class of 2023, but also family and friends. Ladies and gentlemen, as a senior class sponsor, it is my distinct privilege to introduce to you the principal of Eastland High School, Mr. Adam Bramlett.
First, I'd like to say a quick thank you to the Eastland Independent Superintendent and Board of Trustees for making this event possible. If you are present here tonight, please stand and be recognized as I call your name. Superintendent of Schools, Jeremy Williams. Assistant Superintendent, Mary Jones. Board President, Brent Kirkland. Vice President, David Hatton. Secretary, Deidre Sadler. And board members, Kimberly Fullen, Donnie Kate, John Bird, and Marcus Martin. On behalf of the class of 2023, thank you for all of your service to the school and the community and the unselfish contribution that you make to education and the welfare of its youth. The class of 2023 would also like to acknowledge and recognize their senior class sponsor, Ms. Elena Thompson, high school administrative assistant, Crystal Purdom, counselors, Melissa Wilson and Angela Cumba, assistant principal, Patrick Odom, and then Brian, Glenn, and all the guys in the maintenance department, all of whom have been instrumental in the preparation of this special event. Please join me in a round of applause. To the class of 2023, you've had your share of heartbreak and adversity since you graduated to the Hill in August of 2016. It started with the loss of a beloved classmate in middle school, a pandemic that cost you the end of your freshman year, fires last spring that cost several of you your homes and your possessions. I hope you learned a valuable lesson in all these things, that in life it's not necessarily what happens to you, but it's about how you react to each situation. You can be a victim, or you can be a problem solver. What was great for me to see over the last several years was how these students reacted in those situations. They desired to be part of the healing process, whether it was surrounding the families in their time of tragic loss, to volunteering their time to be a friendly face to members of our community that were affected by the fire. It was great to be at the Dome and watch these kids come in with their eyes wide open, and by the next 30 minutes, they're reaching out, helping the members of our community that were devastated by the fire. And they all volunteered. They all gave up their time to be down at the Dome to help out their community. As teachers, directors, coaches, parents, family members, and community, we've tried to protect you from the dangers of this world, but at the same time, we've tried to prepare you to find your place in this world. Some of you will leave tonight to head to college, others to military, some straight to the workforce, and some to trade school. But as you enter, be aware that all these lessons that you've learned over the last 18, 19 years are now going to become voices in your head. A lot of times when we talk about voices in your head, we're talking about people that are hearing the strange voices. But I'm talking about the voices in your head that are pushing you to do different things. You have to learn to decipher those voices. You're gonna have your parents' voice in your head. You're gonna have your family members, your friends. You're gonna have coaches, directors, Ms. Williams, Mr. Rainey. You're gonna have Mr. Knott. All the people that have poured themselves into you for the last several years, they're now gonna become voices in your head. Learn to listen to these voices. Also learn to decipher the voices of doubt, the voices of fear, because they're gonna be there. Some of you have expressed the voice of fear already. It's like you've waited for this moment your whole life and now it's here, and now it's like, oh no. What am I gonna do Monday morning when I don't have to be up at 8 o'clock? Let's be honest, some of you aren't up at 8 o'clock this year. I hope after all these things, you've learned to listen to these voices. You have to act when the opportunity presents itself. Guys, great things don't just happen to people. hard work and sacrifice, but when an opportunity presents itself, you've got to take action. You can't stand by and wait, because if you do, it's going to pass you by. I want to leave you with two things, short and simple. Always remember that as you look out tonight and look across this room, all these people that are here, you have a community here that has your back and wants nothing more for you to succeed. Whatever it is you choose to do, like I said, if you're going to college, do great things. If you're going to the military, do great things. If you're going to work, do great things. In all these things, remember who you are and remember whose you are. At this time, I'd like to ask Derek Harris to make his way up here and ask for you all to stand for the invocation. Please remain standing after the invocation for the national anthem.
Please bow in prayer with me. Lord, we come to you today with hearts full of gratitude and bittersweetness. Today marks a day of closing, but also a day of new beginnings for the students and families in this place. I pray that the accomplishments of each student here does not go unrewarded. I pray for your richest blessings over each student here today. I pray that the relationships built in the walls of that school building will continue to grow and prosper even as we all go our separate ways. Bless each mother, father, friend, teacher, and faculty member that has poured into each of our lives and touched our hearts in a way that we will carry with us forever. I also pray for peace in the uncertainty. When we're lost or do not know what to do at the next turn, I hope that we will always run to you and cling to your lamb guiding our path. Lastly, I pray for everyone's safety on the travels home and in each future endeavor. May we all live for you and constantly pursue your love and guidance in all that we do. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
You may be seated. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry, jumped the gun. Now you may be seated. Thank you, Derek, and thank you, Mr. Knott, for leading us in the National Anthem. We will now introduce our 2022-2023 Maverick of the Year. This student was selected by the teachers of Eastland High School and fully represents what it means to be a Maverick. She is not only a dedicated student athlete, but she strives to be a leader in all of her endeavors. She's a role model to the younger Mavericks, and a servant in the community. The student has the privilege of coming before you to provide recognition to the most important people in their education other than their family. This year's recipient of the Maverick of the Year Award goes to Miss Michaela Henry.
Well, I never really understood why people told me if I got nervous before or while giving this speech to just imagine the audience naked, because now I just feel very uncomfortable and I'm not sure I can look at any of you the same. When finding out I received the honor of being the 2023 Maverick of the Year, my first thought was, this has nothing to do with me, but everything to do with the people who have helped shape me into the person I am today. You see, today is a good day. Not because I finally got Coach Rogers to admit he actually does like me and will miss me, but today is a good day because as I look around, I see my classmates, teachers, administrators, coaches, family, friends, and many people who made today possible. Not only that, I see many of the people who shaped me into the person I am today. Therefore, I am beyond thankful to receive the honor of being the Maverick of the Year that was only made possible by the supportive, uplifting, and hardworking environment the Maverick family has provided to me, which led to my desire of living up to the Maverick standard these past 4 years. Throughout high school, I definitely learned a lot. I learned anything from sine, cosine, and tangent in Algebra 2, which I'm still not sure why, but I did, to how to have grit, integrity, character, and selflessness in everything I do. While attending Eastland High School, I not only got a good education, but I gained many intangible characteristics that I'll be able to carry with me as I begin this new chapter in my life. Therefore, I'd like to take some time to thank some people tonight who made living up to the Maverick standard possible and worth it. To my classmates, I want to thank you for making the past 4 years so much fun and my past 10 years at Eastland ISD filled with so many memories. I'll forever hold our time together close to my heart, and I can't wait to see what y'all do in this next chapter. To the teachers, this is a very special thanks, because you are the ones who chose to give me this honor tonight. There are so many here who are deserving of this award, so thank you for choosing me. Also, a huge thank you for the immense amount of effort, countless hours, and unrecognized work you have all put into me and every student here. Because of you all, we can step into this next chapter of our lives. To my coaches, thank you for pushing me, coaching me, and being the best role models. Thank you for teaching me how to work hard and the difference in character and reputation. Each one of you cares about me so much and every athlete, and it shows. I'll forever try to reach the high level of character you have displayed to me every day. Thank you all for all the love, passion, and selflessness you have shown to me over the years. To my family and loved ones, I want to thank you for being the biggest and best support system a girl could ask for. You all mean so much to me, and I cannot thank you enough for all your love and support. I'd like to give an extended and special thanks to my parents. You two have been the most loving and selfless people I have ever come across. Lastly, but most importantly, I would like to thank God for the abundance of blessings and opportunities he has given to me. Without him, nothing is possible. I would now like to leave you all with one of my favorite quotes by John Wooden. Be more concerned with your character than your reputation, because your character is what you really are, while your reputation is merely what others think you are. Thank you.
Thank you, Michaela, for the words you have shared about our amazing faculty and staff, and everyone who has influenced your time here at Eastland ISD. And now, I would like to introduce to you our salutatorian, Ms. Anna Celeste Rodriguez. She will be attending the University of Texas and pursuing a degree in biology. Today, she is proudly wearing a white stole, signifying her persistence and dedication to her education. To the class of 2023 salutatorian, Ms. Anna Celeste Rodriguez.
Quick message before I start my speech. I want to tell my family and the audience to start recording or be on your Facebook Lives because who knows if my mom made it to graduation. All right. I would like to open my speech by saying thank you to all those who have impacted my journey. To my parents, thank you for your guidance, support, and unconditional love. I have put you guys on y'all's toes with activities and academics. And after a certain grade, y'all were unable to help me with my homework. However, I never stopped learning from y'all and instead learned the qualities of what I consider to be street smart. No matter my choices, you followed me and never let me give up. Thanks to my siblings for always giving me a tough time, but also preparing me for adulthood. So shout out to Khalees. Stop stealing my clothes, and I see you made my graduation about you. I currently do not have a problem with Javier yet, and Giovanni, you still cannot have my room. Bigger shout out to the Eastland Donut Shop just down the road because you came in clutch. In the first semester of this year, I would sell the donuts to students and make a profit. I later figured out that if I got one before an exam, I later figured out that eating a donut would help me retain memory, so I would pop over to get one before an exam. So far, I have yet to make below an A on an exam, but you still must study for it to work. Thanks to the teachers for pushing me to learn more, being able to help understand my busy schedule, and for guiding me to success. Heads up, if you have any of my siblings, let's just say be thankful you had me because you will soon find out. Special thanks to Mr. Knott and Coach Sheffield. Mr. Knott became my therapist, heard me vent, and apparently dealt with my so-called bombastic side eyes. Coach Sheffield took me in junior year, considered me family, and also taught me to be a part of TFB. They both stepped into some big shoes and knew that they had to rebuild a foundation for the years to come. They shaped my leadership skills, were proud to hear my future, and made the best out of my senior year. Ms. Kumba, thank you for being my school mom and for caring for each one of your students. Even after becoming a counselor, you took the time out of your day to make sure our future and education were met. I will most especially miss our Wordle days and stealing your chocolate from your office. When using my friend Google on what a salutatorian does and is, it told me to give an address of welcome and called me the first loser. However, I will not be giving that address of welcome or consider myself a loser. Getting a diploma is an award and everyone should be proud, whether it's first or last. I am especially proud of how far I have come and grown and continue to do so. If you told me in the second grade, when I moved here, that I would be giving a speech, she would have laughed straight at your face. I was diagnosed with dyslexia when I moved here and hid myself from fear of being made fun of. I made the choice to spend my time studying so that I could take control of my dream. And as my family knows me as my aunt's name, Minnie Udy, because she went to the University of Texas at Austin, or for bringing my computer to family events to finish work. I established a worth ethic that brings me here to give you this speech. So, to my classmates, do your job so darn well that no one can tell you how it should be done, whether it be college, trade school, the military, or even jumping straight into the workforce. After graduation, we will be away from our families and create a new home for ourselves, which is scary because just like yesterday, it feels like we were in elementary. Our future will be the outcome of our choices. So I challenge each and every one of my classmates to make the most out of every day. And with that, at the end of the day, there will be no excuses, no explanations, and especially no regrets. Lastly, a special quote that is near and dear to my heart from my Saint Catherine of Siena. Be who God made you to be, and you will set the world on fire. Thank you.
Anna Celeste, thank you for sharing and being invested in your school, community, and family. It is an honor to have you share with us this evening as we get to celebrate the ending of one of life's most memorable stages and the beginning of the next one. At this time, we will recognize different groups of students who have received the academic awards and scholarships. As we go through the awards, please feel free to applaud each group or individual at the end of their recognition. The first award we have tonight is the one that is chosen by the senior class. This year's Mr. and Miss EHS are Mr. Fabian Innocencio and Ms. Hallie Barker. You may be seated. The Eastland High School faculty selected the best citizen for 2022-2023. These awards go to Mr. Jesus Lopez and Ms. Hallie Barker. You may be seated.
Another group of seniors that we will recognize at this time are the Eastland High School Students of the Month. Each month, the EHS faculty is asked to vote on one boy and one girl. Graduates, please rise and remain standing as your name is called. Joel Hernandez and Hallie Barker. Xander Brown and Michaela Henry. Jesus Lopez and Audrey Ivey.
Austin Taminga and Leslie Vasquez. Joseph McRae Allen and Melanie Rojas. Fabian Incencio and Maddie Blaylock. Vincent McCleskey and Taylor Clark. Chase Price and Maria Elenez Alegria. Nathan Taylor and Emily Ojeda. Thank you. You may be seated. Beta Club members are wearing gold stoles. In order to become a member of the Eastland High School Beta Club, students must have an overall GPA of 93 or above. Will the Beta Club graduates please stand? Thank you. You may be seated. The Distinguished Achievement graduates are wearing red cords. Students graduating with a Distinguished Achievement graduation plan chose the plan with the most rigorous coursework and requirements. Will the Distinguished Achievement graduates please stand? Thank you. You may be seated. Honor graduates are wearing gold cords. To graduate with honors, you must have an overall four-year cumulative GPA of 90 or above. Will the honor graduates please stand? Thank you. You may be seated. We also want to take the time to acknowledge the student organizations here at EHS. The sponsors have given the students stoles and cords to recognize their achievements. If you have received a cord or stole from ag, art, or band, would you please stand? Thank you. You may be seated. The state of Texas recognizes those students graduating in the top 10 of their class. These students are wearing the gold medallion. The top 10 students of this class of 2023 are Taylor Clark, Anna Celeste Rodriguez, Melanie Rojas, Michaela Henry, Austin Taminga, Emily Ojeda, Maria Elenez Alegria, Joel Hernandez, Alicia Rodriguez, and Leslie Vasquez. Thank you. You may be seated. Our school would like to take a moment to recognize the student with the top ACT and SAT scores. As you all know, these are extremely challenging assessments. Not only can higher scores open the doors for students to gain entrance into the college of their choice, it may also open up more possibilities for college scholarships as well. This year, the highest ACT and SAT belongs to Ms. Taylor Clark. Thank you. You may be seated.
This year, we have a few students wearing blue cords or gold stoles who were inducted into Phi Theta Kappa. Phi Theta Kappa is a junior college honor society, and in order to be inducted as a member, a student must have a 3.5 cumulative grade point average with a total of 12 college credit hours or more. Members must also maintain a 3.0 GPA. Will the members of Phi Theta Kappa please rise?
Thank you.
At EHS, students can begin taking dual credit courses their sophomore year. Some of those students work toward earning their associate's degree. Overall, this senior class is graduating with just over 1,300 hours of college credit. In early May, we had 9 students graduate with their associate's degree from Cisco College and Ranger College. With us tonight from Ranger College, we have Lindy Matthews, Vice President of Institutional Advancement. And from Cisco College, we have Professor William Haygood. The following students received associate degrees from both Ranger College and Cisco College. Please stand when your name is called. Taylor Clark. Anna Celeste Rodriguez. Joel Hernandez. Melanie Rojas. Michaela Henry. Emily Ojeda. Austin Tamika. Leslie Vasquez. And Derek Harris. You may be seated. This year we have several students wearing a purple stole, which signifies their participation in two collegiate programs that provide preparation and support to high school students. The TRIO program at Tarleton University and the Ranger Upward Bound program at Ranger College. These programs provide opportunities for participants to succeed in their pre-college performance and ultimately in their higher education pursuits. The support that these two institutions have shown to our students is immensely appreciated. Will the participants in the TRIO program please stand? Thank you. You may be seated. Will the participants in the Ranger Upward Bound program please stand? Our students have worked diligently to apply and receive numerous scholarships. Many of these scholarships are from the generous support from local donors in our community. We have a large number of graduating seniors receiving local scholarships totaling over $85,000. If you are one of the students receiving any type of scholarship, please stand at this time. We also have four students who have enlisted to serve our great nation in the United States military. These students are Sean Clayton, Marines, Vincent McCleskey, Marines, Braden Hugh, Navy, and Nathaniel Taylor, Army.
At this time, I take honor of presenting Ms. Taylor Clark, the valedictorian of the 2023 graduating class. Taylor received the State of Texas Honor Graduate Certificate, which entitles her to a scholarship for tuition to any state college or university in Texas. She will be attending Midwestern State University, pursuing a degree in political science. Taylor is also wearing white stole, representing her dedication and persistence to excellence. Ladies and gentlemen, Taylor will now show her valedictory address.
Sorry. Good evening, respected graduates, faculty, and guests. Before I begin, I would like to thank the teachers, administrators, janitors, cafeteria workers, counselors, receptionists, community members, and all the people who make Eastland ISD run as smoothly as possible. This world would not be able to function without the time, effort, and space educators give in order for their students to grow and become whoever they want to be. I would also like to thank the coaches, sponsors, and band directors for encouraging and pushing us to work hard to achieve what at first may seem like impossible goals. I obviously would also like to thank all the parents who helped these graduates behind me get to this point in our educational careers. And without them, none of this would have been possible. And lastly, I would like to thank my family, to whom I owe all my successes, loves, and life to. Thank you to Casey and Chase, who are the best siblings a person could ever ask for. And the kid in me will always miss arguing who has to sit in the middle seat. Just so y'all know, I don't mind. I never would have put myself out there if I didn't see my siblings do it first. And thank you to my parents for constantly listening to my many pointless rants at our kitchen table and encouraging me to not settle for anything less than what I worked for. I love y'all both bunches, and I wouldn't be giving this speech if it wasn't for y'all's love and support. And to my class, the class of 2023, we did it. We overcame the online work no one did during COVID. The mandatory mask policy that you had to follow even when needing your mouth. Being told that maybe we didn't know that much algebra in the middle of Algebra 2. And submitting many college applications that thankfully did not need our ACT or SAT score. But here we are, 4 years later, about to receive our diplomas for being able to endure hardships and achievements from our time at Eastland High School. Our persistence should not stop at the end of our high school careers, but we should strive to show this resilience within our future colleges, workplaces, and relationships. It seems like only yesterday that many of us were getting to know fellow classmates in tiny kindergarten chairs, doing sports that our parents made us play, and thinking, oh, 2023 is so far away. Well, unfortunately, we've hit our due date. That 2023 that seems so far away is glaring right into our faces as we speak. We have all our requirements and checked our rubrics one last time. There is no more time for, as Joel likes to say, that's Friday's problem. I don't know if you've all checked a calendar recently, but today's Friday, so now I guess it's our problem. The problem of growing up and leaving high school behind and asking yourself, what am I supposed to do now? So let's face this obstacle of adulthood head on, because we are a resilient bunch. Take what you've learned from these past 18 years and apply it towards your ever-changing future. As we reflect on our journey through high school, I would like to share a quote with you all that I hope can help you someday in the future. Of course, this quote comes from none other than Harry Styles. He once said, if you're happy doing what you're doing, then nobody can tell you you're not successful. So I urge you all to pursue careers that you are genuinely interested in and can never become bored of. Success is not measured by the money you make or having the most accomplishments, but true success is found within your joy for what you do and how you share that with others. If you love kids, become a teacher. If you love attending to others, become a nurse. But don't ever seek a career because someone else wants you to. This is your life. You might as well do something that makes you happy to go there every day. And no amount of money can ever measure up to the reward you feel, the success of happiness in your own life. This class has walked a fine line of amazing feats and hard tribulations, but the love and support we have for our community and each other has made life just a little bit easier. It has been an absolute pleasure to be a part of this class, and I am so excited to see what change we can make in this world. So, class of 2023, I encourage you all to keep moving forward, pursuing what you love, and to never lose that tenacity that has always made us overcome adversity, and to always, always treat others with kindness. I think if we do all that, we'll be all right. Thank you. And for the last time, go Bears!
Taylor, thank you for reminding us to celebrate the small victories and recognizing the importance of having support from your community, friends, and family. We see how others may endure hardships and still rise above. Taylor and the class of 2023, we know you will make us proud. Now we come to the high point in our ceremony, where our seniors will receive their hard-earned diplomas this evening. The certificates will be presented by Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Jeremy Williams, Mr. Adam Bramlin, and the members of the school board. Will the first row of candidates please rise? Caleb Cole Fortenberry.
Maria Karen Alaniz Alegria. Joseph McCray Allen. Alan Alvarez. Hallie Marie Barker. Nicole Leanne Blankenship. Madison Lynn Blaylock. Kendall Marie Bradford. Jersey Ray Brown. Xander Alex Brown. Kylie Joy Carver. Yorhelis Maria Carizales. Cadence Jean Cheney. Taylor Lynn Clark. Sean David Clayton. Amber Sky Contreras. Tyler Dale Douglas. Justice Elizabeth Jean Dove. Zayden Blaine Fox. Anastasia Elizabeth Freitag. Hannah Michelle Green. Derek Kyle Harris. Michaela Jacqueline Henry. Jacob Chewy Hernandez Jr. Joel Hernandez. Kaylee Ashlyn Hernandez. Trey Anthony Hyatt. Fabian Inocencio Jr. Audrey Rose Ivy. Kaylani McKay Jimenez. Haley Mae Jordan. Jaden K. Justice. Carly Nicole Kennedy. Derek Freeman Keller. Candace Jade Kendricks. Jesus Lopez. Kaylin Marie Lopez. Vincent Robert McCleskey. Isaiah Edgar Medina. Allison Mercer. Kaylee Ray Nichols. Kaylin Joyce Nicholson. Isaiah Braylon Ochoa. Kaylin Emily Ojeda.
Yahir Ojeda.
Michelle Ibarra Palomares. Hannah Abigail Perkins. Erin Nicole Phillips. Fernando Pina. Yeah. Chase Ryder Price. Yeah. Braden Clinton Pugh. Daylen Joshua Ramirez. Yay. Dylan Dusty Randall. Reseda Maria Regosa. Damian Zane Ryan. Sydney Paige Richter. Anna Celeste Rodriguez. Cicely Layla Rodriguez. Alicia Elizabeth Rodriguez. Melanie Rojas. Samantha Brianne Samora. David William Smith. Jackson Daniel Smith.
Austin Paul Taminga. Nathaniel Derek Taylor. Tommy Jack Tucker. Leslie Nicole Vasquez. Einstein Ray Kilo Villaruz. Weston Ty Weeks. Lainey Nicole Wilkinson. Samara Isabel Rivera Wurtzman.
The class of 2023, please rise. Mr. Williams and members of the Eastland Independent School District Board of Trustees, with affirmation that these candidates have completed the requirements established by the TEA and the Eastland ISD Board of Trustees, I recommend that these candidates before you be certified as graduates with all the rights and privileges thereof. We declare you graduates of Eastland High School, class of 2023. Now, following tradition, just like this morning, the graduates will now sing the alma mater. Please stand for the benediction, which will be delivered by Ms. Michaela Henry.
Please pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, today we come together to celebrate the end of one chapter and the beginning of another. As our classes and high school activities have come to an end, let us use what we have learned throughout them for the betterment of your kingdom and for your glory. I ask, Lord, that you will be with each graduate here tonight and that they will fulfill what you have in store for them. I also ask that you will be with the teachers, administrators, friends, family, and anyone else in attendance tonight. Cover them with your grace, love, and protection. Protect everyone here as they make their way home tonight. Thank you, Lord, for all you have blessed us with and making tonight possible. We love and thank you for all you do. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
You may be seated. I now invite Cole Bridges, junior class president, who will now light the symbolic lamp of knowledge. The lamp of knowledge is a special, long-standing tradition we have here at EHS. We understand that everyone is eager and in a hurry to get to the get their graduate and start taking their pictures. But while Cole is lighting the lamp, I need to respectfully ask parents and patrons, at the conclusion of this traditional ceremony, please refrain from leaving your seats until the graduates have had the opportunity to briefly gather together in the foyer one last time. And now I present Mr. Cole Bridges.
It is my honor as a junior class president to light the lamp of knowledge. Class of 2023, this light of the lamp of knowledge represents all the valuable experiences you have encountered from kindergarten until tonight. Under the guidance of your parents, elementary, middle school, and high school teachers, coaches and sponsors, your employers, college professors, and peers, you have received the gifts of many talents and many life lessons. Consider yourselves equipped. Equipped for higher education, equipped for your job field, and equipped for real life. For the last 13 years, you have been in training. In a moment, when you exit, you will light your candle. You will walk out the back doors carrying your own torch, taking all that you have learned and all that you have become. And then the training is over. Real life is here. This is where the work comes in. Take all that you have learned and apply it out there. On behalf of the junior class, we thank you for your leadership. We have some big shoes to fill, and we wish you the best. Congratulations, class of 2023. Will the first row graduates please rise to recess?